Hi, my name is Jason Bagnell with JB Computer Services in Casselberry, Florida, just outside Orlando. The reason I made this video is to introduce you to a new technology that can make a big difference in your day-to-day computer life. This technology is called SSD, or Solid State Drive. This little device here works just like a computer hard drive. It's the same size, has the same interface, except it's very, very much faster because there are no moving parts. Due to that, we can take a regular computer hard disk drive, copy the contents onto the solid state drive, and then install this in the computer instead. And then the performance can be measured and compared. And I'd like to run through a test of this with you. I have here a Dell Inspiron laptop, which has just a normal regular hard disk drive in there. I've used it off and on for years, and it's a good machine, but a little slow. I would consider getting a brand new laptop, but right now I don't want to incur the cost. So that's where the SSD drives fill the gap. They allow you to purchase something that's about half or less the price of a new computer, yet give blazing performance. So in this video, I'm going to show you the process I go through to install and test these drives, and we'll go over the results together. I'd like to give you a little information about the cloning process. The first step is I remove the original hard drive from the desktop computer or laptop computer, and then I install it in a machine I use to do disk cloning. You can see the removed drive is on the right from a Dell laptop, and the new OCZ Vertex 2 solid state drive is on the left. Next, I use a program such as Acronis True Image or Symantec Ghost to actually clone an image from the old drive to the new SSD drive. Once that procedure is complete, the new SSD drive is put into the computer and testing begins. Okay, the solid state drive has successfully copied an image of the original hard disk drive, and I've installed the SSD drive in a Dell Inspiron E1505 laptop. This laptop has 1 GB of memory, Windows XP Professional, and it also has an Intel Core Duo processor at 1.66 GHz. So I'm going to get a timer in front of us, and we'll go ahead and time the boot up. I'm going to start timing as soon as the Dell screen disappears. Should be right now. And what we're looking for is just much, much better performance than the regular hard drive, which I'll show you next. It's in the middle of booting from the solid state drives. When it comes up to the Windows screen, I also have in the startup group 10 programs that are going to run all at the same time immediately right when it boots up. That's normally a very, very tough thing for any computer with a regular hard drive. It will be loading Microsoft Outlook, Word, Excel, PowerPoint, Publisher, America Online 9.5, which normally takes a very long time to load, Internet Explorer, Malwarebytes Anti-Malware, CCleaner, and the Task Manager, so I can monitor when everything is booted up and it's fully ready to be used. So it looks like we're already almost at the desktop screen at 42 seconds. And there we go. And applications are starting to load up. And again, this is 10 programs instantly at the same time while Windows is in the middle of finishing booting up itself. Also, I guess an 11th program would be the antivirus software that has to load in the background too. So 1 minute and 2 seconds. It's doing well. There's the task manager, PowerPoint. I do see the CPU utilization is up at 100%, which means that the drive is actually giving it data faster than the processor can even process it. Sometimes on older computers, at some point you have to have a faster processor to have more speed, but the SSD drive will help any system just because it eliminates all the waiting, or the majority of the waiting for the hard disk. Okay, 1 minute 33 seconds, it still has CPU utilization. As soon as that stays around zero, I'll stop the timer. Okay, there. It looks like it's pretty much done and ready. And so our time with the solid state drive is 1 minute and 40 seconds. The next test, I'll put the original disk drive in that has the exact same image. It's going to run the same test, run the same programs, and we'll time just to see how long it takes if you did not have a solid state disk drive. Now, for this test, we're going to test the laptop with its original hard drive. This would be like you without a solid-state disk drive, just to see how long it takes in comparison to with the solid-state drive. The number we're trying to beat, and it's not going to, but the number that it would have to beat is 1 minute 40 seconds. So here's our timer, and I'll go ahead and hit the power button on here. As soon as the Dell screen disappears, I'll go ahead and start our time. Go. There we go. Now, it's off, so not being a solid state, I do expect a lot longer. The question is how much longer versus how much money to get the extra speed, and we're about to find out. Now, remember, the regular hard disk drives do have moving parts. They can't transfer data in and out as fast. There's a delay between every single time they move to access a file. They have to physically move the drive head over, locate the file and then start reading. And if two programs at the same time are trying to load, then it just even adds more to the wait. So I don't expect this test to do very well because we're opening 10 programs. Some people's computers over the years will collect things that run at startup that you don't even know are in there. So that causes a lot of slowdown and actually can be fixed pretty easily just by using msconfig or going into your startup group and just eliminating things that you don't want running all the time. You don't have to lose the program altogether, but if you don't need it when it boots up, why have the computer bother even loading it? So looks like we've got the welcome screen. We're coming up on getting the main desktop, and it's still cranking away. I've got a solid hard drive light. We're at a minute 12, and we just hit the desktop, and now it's going to go through and try to run the same programs that the other one did. Remember, it's at the same instant trying to load Outlook, Word, Excel, PowerPoint, Publisher, AOL 9.5, Internet Explorer, Malwarebytes, CCleaner, and the Task Manager. Which that's quite a mouthful, and we'll see what happens. So far, the desktop was up, CCleaner's loading. There's the Task Manager that allows us to monitor and see how much it's thinking in comparison to how fast the programs are popping up. Word's popping in the background. And I do know America Online has always been a huge application. I'm not really a fan of their software, but it would be good in this test, so that's why I threw it in there. So we've got Excel, PowerPoint, Task Manager, CCleaner, Publisher, Word, and then also in the background it's loading the antivirus software to protect the computer. Looks like Publisher, Outlook is there. CPU utilization is still quite high, not as high as it was with the SSD because this drive's unable to feed it quite as fast as the other drive, actually not near as fast as the other drive. It's still busy booting up and loading. This is the part where I'm sure most people are going to forward through the video because it takes a long time, as you can imagine. So we're getting close towards the inside of this procedure, but it's not there yet, so we'll let it keep scanning. And the number we were trying to beat is 1 minute and 39 seconds. So far, we're at 2 minutes and 42 seconds. So already way, way slower than having the SSD. So, and every little second you save having this faster drive will save you that time every time. So if you compound the time of waiting for your computer to boot up over 4 years and waiting for Internet Explorer and QuickBooks and Outlook with a huge data file, it's not just one time you're going to save it, it's every time. So, you know, your productivity can actually be a lot greater. So it's still processing. Google's trying to come up. I see a white screen. There's Google. And still thinking. Believe it or not, I think we've hit a point where the SSD is already twice as fast, if not more. And I think we're somewhat close to the very end. There's America Online, finally. And it's still processing. This is unbelievable. Does this make you want to get a solid-state disk drive? I hope so. If you like not to wait for your computer, it's a very good thing. Okay, CPU utilization is still going up. It's coming down, and we'll call it quits there. We'll give it the benefit of the doubt because it looks like it's hardly accessing much of anything. So 3 minutes 49 seconds compared to 1 minute and 40 seconds. So hands down, the solid state drive saves a lot of time. It's very fast. The computers like it a lot better. And I highly, highly recommend them.
So as you've seen, swapping your hard disk drive for a solid state drive can provide a huge performance improvement, let alone keep you from having to buy that new computer quite so soon. Even the new computer that you buy will have a hard drive that most likely won't anywhere touch the performance of the solid state drive. At the current time, the 80 gigabyte SSDs can be found for about $159. The 120 gigabyte SSD, and the one I'm talking about is by the company named OCZ. This is a Vertex 2. I don't want to try the regular Vertex because this is faster and better. There's also a Vertex 3, which supports the new serial ATA3, newer, better, faster, but a lot more expensive too. And again, the 120 gigabyte version of that is on sale at Newegg right at the time of this video for $179.99. And the one that I used in my video, the 50 gigabyte, cost me less than $100 from Amazon.com. So they're not too expensive. They do have to be installed, either by somebody like me, or if you're tech savvy, you can attempt to install one yourself. But I do recommend, if you're not a tech guru, have somebody like me install it for you. There can be some headaches that you run into during the installation process. If you have any questions about what you've seen or are interested in the technology and would like to try an SSD in your computer to help get blazing performance compared to what you have and save you from upgrading your whole computer, give me a call. My number is 407-478-5800. My name is Jason Bagnell, and I can also be reached by email at jason@jbyte.com. It's J-A-S-O-N @J-B-Y-T-E.com. Thanks for watching.